want to say a few words about the COVID crisis. This week marked another tragic milestone in our fight against COVID-19. More than 3,000 deaths in one single day, the highest single death count during this pandemic. That's more deaths in a single day than we saw on 9/11 or at Pearl Harbor. This is serious business. And the current director of the CDC said yesterday, we can expect the similar numbers of deaths or more every single day for the next 60 to 90 days. We're in the teeth of a crisis right now. And this nation needs presidential leadership right now. Presidential leadership that is willing to model the steps we should be taking to save our own lives and lives of our families. You know, we can wish this away, but we have to face it head on. We have to take it head on. Using every power available to me as president, we'll have a national coordinated strategy that will beat this virus. You know, and as tough as things are now, I firmly believe better days are ahead. We've got some good news yesterday. The FDA committee recommended emergency use authorization for Pfizer's BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine. But we're grateful for the scientists at these, not only there, but other great organizations, researchers who developed this vaccine and several others on the way. And we're just as grateful to the scientists and the public experts who evaluated its safety and efficacy free from political influence. I want to make it clear to the public, you should have confidence in this. There is no political influence. These are first-rate scientists taking their time looking at all of the elements that need to be looked at. Scientific integrity led us to this point. We know the immense challenges and hard work ahead. Earlier this week, I announced our COVID response team that'll scale up the manufacturing, distribution, and injection of the vaccine. We set a bold and doable challenge in my first 100 days, 100 million shots in 100 days, asking the American people to wear masks for the first 100 days of our administration. And if we get the necessary funding from Congress, we can get most of our schools open in 100 days, but we need the help from the Congress and the funding. The first 100 days won't end the COVID-19, but meeting those goals can slow the spread, save lives, and get us back to our lives with the people we love the most.